Hey everybody, it's Drogoth here with game number two of the lower bracket finals matchup in this New England StarCraft II League qualifier number two. Again, this is number two on Icy Cup, Neo Enigma, Damcats as the blue Zerg player in the upper right hand corner of the map, and Recon as the teal Terran in the upper left. Now on the last matchup on Icy Cup Valhalla, Damcats had some very good pressure, however, was not able to capitalize on harassment or any surround, though he did do some good damage. Recon just had too much of a unit output and regen, which is very surprising considering that Damcats was working off of five hatcheries and able to pull out many lings. Now, something that may have caused a problem with that was the heavy focus on the speedlings and a couple of banelings, and not really focusing on getting any roaches and hydras into the mix, which might have worked on that bio ball. Not really sure. Infestors, we do know for sure, would have really hurt. And I do believe he had just actually teched up to that at the end. Recon did a great job. He actually went into the second expansion, right off of the natural, putting down a planetary fortress. Now, that stationary defense that the planetary fortress did, because of the way that the map is set up, he was able to cover both lanes of attack into that natural expansion, plus his new base on that planetary fortress. Damcats coming back around. He actually stopped this barracks from coming up a little bit. That delay, doing very good. And he actually fast expanded out of here very quickly before the spawning pool. So he went down with these, what was that, a 16 hatch, 15 pool. A little bit of a stutter right there as Fraps was doing its own little thing, as we have seen throughout the rest of the day, though everything is okay. And as I said, Damcats being able to get that expansion down extremely quickly, the 16, 15 hatch to pool. And Recon getting a nice little scout and then losing his SEV. Damcats going right back to mining. Great job by Damcats getting that surround on him. However, we do see a factory coming out by Recon. So chances are Recon will be doing the same type of build. Looking at where the supply depot was, it looks like Recon might have actually put his spacing down wrong. However, with where this is... Oh, actually, no. If Recon lifts up and plans right here, he will be able to put down... a tech building or a reactor onto the side of that barracks. However, where he is now, I'm not really sure if there's enough room in this small little corner. There may or may not be. However, with oversight from this side, that will easily be sniped off, where as opposed to a supply depot, which has the same amount of HP, but has less of an effect laid towards the middle, early stages of the game when there are a plenty supply depots. Damcats right now really focusing on getting those drones up, getting his economy up. He's going to try and out macro right away Recon, trying to get his economy really kicking and pushing hard into it. There is a possibility that he might move into the gold if he keeps up some, or if he initiates some type of pressure. Recon actually leaving his front door open, so going to be coming out with some type of harass. Looks like he's going to be doing a Marine Hellion harass to finish this off in two games, pushing Damcats into third place and going to end up facing his hero, Green Ranger. I don't know if they're heroes, but they're on the same team. Team Alpha, they came in the same car, and they want to rush out. Again, this is a best-of-three matchup as opposed to a best-of-five, just so they can get home. Infernal Pre-Igniter about 60% of the way done. And here we go with the first Hellion coming over. Spinecrawler has gone down. First shot's going towards that. Infernal Pre-Igniter still not finished. But that Spinecrawler going to be doing a great job of providing additional defense. Damcats getting his queens over to the ramp to stop. Great job by him to stop any type of Hellions from pushing up in there. And he will be able to mineral walk the rest of these drones up into the base if need be. Over on the other side right there, we do see the Infernal Pre-Igniter is about to finish. Yes, so the Blue Flame is done, and the Command Center is about 50% of the way done. Still focusing very heavily on the macro. Damcats getting more and more units out. metabolic boost coming in kind of late, although we do have that Roach Warren coming in, as we do have the upgrade to the Hatchery coming at the same time. Will we be seeing a push out coming in? This is a very strong push with the Blue Flame Hellions and the Marines pushing in with it, though I'm not really sure. No, he's not going to do a full push. He's just going to do some type of harassment, as Recon is coming in with the tanks now as opposed to the Hellions. So expect to see these Hellions coming out, keeping this Queen on the ramp, like Ed said, to block any type of push in there. However, if they are not too... If he does not do what he's supposed to right, or rather the range of the Hellions can actually outrange the Queens, so the Hellions will be able to start attacking that. Damcat's actually moving his units back. Look like he's going to be spewing some larva onto the layer right there. And the Hellions, do they move in? No, the Hellions are not moving in, but we do have a lot of upgrades coming down by Damcat's Hellions pushing up into the Zerg. Couple of Roaches there, couple of Speedlings. Yeah, one, no, none of them taken down. However, six, count them, 1, 2, 3, 6 of those Zerglings did go down. There is only one left, and the two Roaches that were there did stay alive, as they are counted as armored units, so they do not take the extra damage from that blue flame. We do have a mass of overlords coming over here, as they were queued over here, possibly part of that Roach group. And it looks like Damcats might be focusing very heavily on a Roach push, trying to push into the map. However, siege tanks, tons of SCVs pushing over. It looked like he actually moved way too many SCVs. Recon actually moved way too many SCVs, though he does have the reactor going. He does have double upgrades going on that tech lab. And these barracks are just forcing out units. Those three Hellions still alive, so that harass still possible. And look, we have Damcats getting that expansion down. I'm not sure if he realizes that these destructible rocks are here, but he's going to have to take them down to get a smooth transition over to that side of the map. Otherwise, he's going to have to try and figure out what to do. And look at that. One of the Hellions is taken down. We do still see one on the right and one on the left. Moving around. Crap, I'm starting to yawn. And here we go. The Roaches are beginning to push into the map, pushing up. We do have all those tanks for that defense. And here we go. The Roaches still coming in. No, Stim is not done. Shields is not done. So these Roaches are going to be able to do some great damage. And there they go. No scan coming down right now. But all those hit points are going to be regenerated right there. And about half of the Roaches did come up. And oh my god, look at that tank damage that has been done by that. We do not have enough energy on there. We do not have enough energy on there. Scan did go down to catch those Roaches. But once the Roaches get up, they'll be able to burrow again, as they will not be spotted. Do we have those Hellions? Where are those Hellions? It looks like the Hellions may have been actually killed. Yes, the Hellions were taken care of, as we've got a couple of Roaches buried on the way over, sort of as a early warning system. We do have enough... Oh, some awful smell filling my nose right now. Oh, what the crap. Oh. Okay, so Damcat's hatch is up finally, and he does have his drones pushing over as my nostrils are filled with, yeah. Anyways. Unseaged tank by Recon and Marines pushing over. They do have Stim. They do have combat shield. So they are going to be pushing in. Damcat's coming over at the same time. Pushing in. Stim did go down. But look at this Roach sitting in the back over here. No, he's not going to do anything. But this Roach might, you know, pop up, try and snipe something, and do absolutely nothing. Maybe kill this Marine. I don't know. But coming over to the side, we do have those slightly damaged Marines from the harassment. Here we go, Damcats, able to get a couple of those Marines down. Oh, God. I'm sorry, that smell just filling. Centrifugal hooks being done, and a couple of Banelings coming into existence, as well as level 2 missile attack coming down for the Roaches, as they do have the +1 armor. This medevac is healing everything up, and we do have Recon with the siege tank. Siege doing some great splash damage, but not really hurting those guys. And here we come, the Speedlings coming in. There are the Banelings coming up the bottom. Will they be able to hit? No, they're actually only going to do a little bit of damage to those siege tanks, and more Roaches are pushing in right now. Here are these Banelings in the back right here, going to try and catch those Marines off guard, coming around the top. Gonna continue trying to catch them right here, as a nice little concave as Damcat's pushing in with all those units. Banelings chasing right there. And yes, Damcat's pops up that Roach right at the last minute. That's been sitting there. The tank's been taken out, and none of the Banelings are in existence anymore. However, more and more Roaches are coming into play, and we do have a bunker coming up on the front side right there. All those units has been taken out. If Damcat's does not push in right now, he will not be able to see that. However, we do see a couple of Marines are miscued where they are going to go. Damcat's leaving that roach right there, so we will be able to see those units coming into play. But Damcat's actually missing out on the opportunity to attack into those bunkers to catch Recon. Well, he had his pants down, really. And nothing. What are we going to be seeing right now? We do see a layer going up into the hive. Infestation pick coming down. So we may be seeing infestors coming down to deal with this massive bio ball of pure marines. And again, a roach right there going to be, look at this vision that the roach provides. He's able to see that the bunker is coming down. He might be able to see when it finishes. However, this missile turret should be able to spot the roach. It may be just inside of that. While that is happening, Damcat's expanding over into the gold right there. So he is going to be focusing heavily on getting a lot of those units out. We do have plus one ground attack and plus two carapace, or a level two carapace coming up. And no, it actually looks like he does see that unit right there, and Damcats is attacking that with a single marine that was inside that bunker. Roach falling back now. Looking on the side, what do we have over here? A medevac drop is sitting at the bottom of the map right now. Do we have infestors yet? No, but we do have tunneling claws. However, the tunneling claws with this missile turret right there, not going to be able to really do too much. However, they will be able to push in and attack very heartily. More banelings morphing into play, probably somewhere in the back. Where are they? They are somewhere. They are in this mix right here. So tunneling claws about 50% of the way, and an ultralisk cavern is going to be coming into the play. Rangers are over there playing ping pong as opposed to watching the game. I guess they're not sure if Recon's actually going to win. And look at this. Damcat's going around the outside, noticing that the range of the sensor tower is around there. Damcat's going around the outside, so he may be able to sneak around the backside right here and come in. There is only three tanks, and the tanks will not be able to do a good enough damage to all those units. We do have a couple of, look at these spine crawlers coming in, trying to deal with this harass right there. However, the spine crawler is not able to do too much. Look at that. All these units moving in to try and take care of that. And the spine crawlers are actually canceled. Endai Stim did come up. And there we got a couple of speedlings coming in, cleaning up all that action. And nothing. No anti-air coming out by those medevacs. Medevacs coming back once again. And a spine crawler coming down again, as there are only 5 marines left in here. And that's it. Will they get picked up? Yes, they do get picked up again. Once again, I really think that Damcats need to get some anti-air coverage right now, as more and more units are coming in for Recon. However, we do have those three Ultralisks are coming into play. Total units, we do not have any Ultralisks yet. However, those big bad Ultralisks are going to be able to do some nasty damage to that planetary fortress. Even though it does do that 40 damage, the Ultralisks do that extra damage to the big structured units, just not the splash. And here we go, Recon moving in with a large number of marines, large number of tanks right there, tanks sieging up, so we should be seeing a scan coming down to take care of those units. And here we go, the Titans are going to clash right now. All of these roaches coming in and just absolutely smoking all those units. An Ultralisk is on board. Recon did see that there are Ultras there. And Ultras, no, they're not actually going to push into it, as these Roaches are fighting this attack over here. Only a couple of Marines were able to fend this off. Looking at the army sizes between the two, Damcats vastly outnumbers Recon, but still no push at all coming in. Recon trying to transfer some probes possibly over to this gold, where that planetary fortress is, to get some of these minerals. And looking in the back over here, he is heavily producing, trying to get some of those supply depots up, trying to get just more and more units up to amass that army, as he is slowly building it right back up, just not as quickly as Damcats is able to. So Damcats coming in now. We do have the planetary fortress out. However, you will be seeing those Ultras clashing into those Marines, or trying to catch up with those Marines and just tearing through absolutely everything. That planetary fortress should be shrinking very quickly, and the Marines running into the back over there, they will be dying as their stim did just wear out. And here we go, the Ultras just ripping through the line, Roaches ripping through the line. All those Marines are going down. This does look like it may be a GG for Recon, as we do not see a drop coming down, though we do see Damcats expanding once more. A further push. Will Damcats continue onward? Yes, he does continue on. And it looks like, no, he's actually going to let that command center finish building. No, he kills the SCV, and Recon calls GG. So now it is 1-1 between these two Titans trying to battle to get... They only did one match. Yeah, that first match was extremely long. But it's 1-1, so let's see what Recon chooses for a map this